Our customers care a lot about getting a high return on investment for their spend. Making a resilient network without spending just arbitrarily on a lot of products, but putting together a good network design, one that enables continuous monitoring, coming into the new standards, global standards, being able to report within their network what they're seeing, a constant picture of health, being able to do continuous network scans instead of producing with a lot of bodies and a lot of money, a big compliance document, moving from static to dynamic, and doing that in a way that enables them to preserve the big minds for their very, very big problems, because all of our customers are targets. Everybody is. There are people and adversaries that want what they have, want what they see, and want what they do. And we have to assume that everybody has a visitor. And in order to get the best return on investment, that means taking the top talent and focusing them on looking for those very, very hard problems, those very insidious attacks that typical practices won't necessarily find. So then having a good baseline of a resilient network that monitors itself, works in real time, learns as it prevents, where every member of the network, component on the network, is a producer and consumer of information. What keeps our customers up at night is making sure their networks are safe, their agencies are tight, and that they're able to do that on a budget. The financial issues that we're having right now in government will amplify the need for the return on investment and amplify the benefits that come from a connected environment. At McAfee, we call it security connected. In government, they call it continuous monitoring. Other scientists call it a network ecosystem. But this is the practice of, again, every piece of your network, when it stops something, sees something, or blocks it, it learns. And then using a global or proprietary protocol internally and externally, you want to be able to share that information among different agencies and create that situational awareness. And over time, the need to spend less money will actually hopefully help to create these resilient networks, because again, we have to refocus our energy toward what's the most efficient and quick and light speed way to protect our assets, our people, and to again, focus the big minds on the very, very dangerous problems. So I think private industry is very good at two things. One is innovation. The idea of sitting and saying, what are the next big things that we can do? It's all about science. How do we take where we are today and go forward? How do we make life better and more fun? Industry can actually help government do more of this, both in sharing our technical vision, which we're doing more and more of, at least we are at McAfee, and also being, again, as we are at McAfee, absolutely relentless about how we protect and how we go forward and how we discover new technologies. I think the other area where industry's leading is combining the policy into the science of security. We are architecting and building these innovative products to not just comply with global policy, but to guide it and make it so that our cyber networks and our electronics of the future that harbor and transport our information and our well-being are actually guiding how our policymakers worldwide enable that innovation. So again, I think innovation and the combination of policy and science are things that industry does very, very well.